All right, so you guys have seen these kinds of videos before, and I've also made a how-to balance video for the Zhiyun Crane 3 Lab. But now the Crane 3S can handle cinema cameras, so I'm gonna go through the steps of how I'm balancing my brand new used Canon C200 that's rigged out with the LCD screen, these two handles, and I've got the 24-70 Tamron lens attached to it. Before we begin, we want to make sure we half lock all three axes on the gimbal and make sure that we attach any cables and any accessories that you're going to be using on the cinema camera because it will shift the entire weight of your setup. After that, the first step to balancing on any gimbal is to attach the base plate to the camera nice and tight using a coin or a screwdriver. Make sure that the cradle is unlocked by pulling it back, and then as you're sliding the camera onto the cradle, make sure that you're pushing down onto the base plate lock to easily slide it in. Now go ahead and unlock the tilt axis while having one hand on your camera just in case it tips forwards or backwards all of a sudden. And now go ahead and balance the position of your camera on the cradle. You'll have to gently slide the camera in the opposite direction of how the camera is falling. If it falls backwards, slide it forwards. If it falls forwards, slide it backwards. Most of the time, you'll only need to do micro adjustments. Cool, so once you have the camera balanced correctly, we have to adjust our tilt axis. Go ahead and loosen the position screw of the tilt arm and then swing your lens up towards the ceiling and see which way your camera falls. If it falls backwards, push the tilt arm forwards. If it falls forwards, push the tilt arm backwards. You'll probably have to do that a couple times to get it perfectly balanced. You'll know when you've perfectly balanced the tilt axis when you can tilt the camera in any direction and it stays still. Once the tilt arm is good to go, set it to half lock so that the tilt arm doesn't move when we're balancing the next axis, which is the roll axis. Loosen the position screw for the arm, and then on the side of the gimbal, go ahead and unlock the arm, making sure to hold on to the camera in case it falls to either side. Again, depending on which side your camera is falling, you want to push it in the opposite direction. So if it falls left, push it right. If it falls right, push it left. And usually all you need to do are just micro adjustments. When you've got it perfectly balanced, you should be able to tilt the camera in any direction and have it stay completely still. Awesome, now half lock the roll axis and let's move on to the last thing, which is the pan axis. Start by unlocking the arm and loosen the position screw. For this one, we are tilting the entire gimbal on its left side. If it swings clockwise, that means it's too back heavy and you need to push it forwards. If it swings counterclockwise, then it's too front heavy and you need to push it backwards. After a couple micro adjustments, you should be able to tilt the entire gimbal on its side without having the camera move at all. Cool, once that's done, unlock all three axes to double check that the camera is fully balanced and you are good to start shooting. That's it for this video. I hope you guys liked it, quick and simple. And if you did like it, please hit that like button, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell to get notified of every video that I post. I'm gonna be making more videos on the Crane 3S, so make sure you stay up to date on everything. Until then, my name is Alex Chung and I'll see you later. Bye.